When you take your development environment and host it on a machine that's not the ACE or PI server, then you've got to deploy your completed calculations to the machine with the ACE scheduler. And we recommend that you don't run the ACE scheduler or install the ACE scheduler on the development box, even though you can. And the reason for that is because once you register your calculations on one box and move them to another box, the context path or some other notation may change. So we recommend you don't register the module at all using the development environment wizard. What we'd like you to do is relocate the executables or DLLs from the developer's machine to the ACE or PI server. And make sure that when you do that, you're using all the correct references if you're using module paths and things of that nature. Now, if you're using the VB6 or Visual Basic 6 development environment, you'll want to stop your executable process with the ACE manager. Copy all the files from the develop machine to the ACE or PI server. Find the executable itself and execute it by double-clicking. This will register it with the machine, and then simply start the process with the ACE manager. If you're using the .NET environment, there is no need to register the DLLs. The executable's already registered. You simply need to stop the executable process, move all of the files, the DLL, from one machine to the other, and simply run the process in the ACE manager. And at this point, what we ask students to do is in their development environment that they're using, simply deploy an ACE module to one of your neighbor's machines, one of your classmates' machines. Act as if you were working on a development computer, debug and test your module, and deploy it on your neighbor's computer.